This is CHS TV News.
Good morning, Cathedral. We hope you had a great weekend. I'm Vanessa with your morning announcements for Monday, October 25th. Let's start off the show with a message from Ms. Stefaniadico.
Good morning, Cathedral staff and students. What a beautiful day it is. I know it's raining, but it's still beautiful. I just have a few very brief reminders. During lunch, students, you can choose to leave the building. You can eat lunch at your place of business that you've bought your lunch at, or you can choose to eat lunch in your period two class. I know it's raining outside, so outside is not an option today. Once again, make sure that during your lunch that you are not wandering the halls, you're not in the forum, you're in your period two class. I just would like to remind students as well that when you are eating lunch or even during your breaks, that when you are in that classroom, you're sitting quietly, you're not jumping on desks, not that anybody would do that here, but that you are behaving as an appropriate high school student would behave. Teachers that are on supervision during the lunch and the breaks, make sure that when you're walking the halls that you check into the classes to make sure that the students are sitting at their desks. And a reminder that the literacy test is this week. Students, it's in period one, so make sure that you're on time. And your teachers as well will let you know what you need to have with you when you're writing the test. So please, please, this week, be on time. At this point, we have student council that would like to make an announcement.
Thanks, Miss. Good morning, Cathedral. Here are our athletes of the week for this week. This athlete of the week for the senior boys football team is Mateo Bules. Mateo played an incredible game on Friday against St. John Henry Newman. He made numerous tackles from the linebacker and defensive end positions, and he blocked extremely well on offense. He is to be commended for his positive attitude and work ethic at practice and during games all season long. Beatrice Clausen is a grade 9 student playing on the junior girls basketball team. She handles most of the ball handling duties and is the anchor in defense. Beatrice is the leader for the junior girls. She exhibits the same great work in the classroom as she does in the court, making her an excellent student athlete. We look forward to watching Beatrice grow in her academics and sports. Congratulations, Gales. That's it for me. Now back to the desk.
Thank you, Kira. Halloween for Hunger students who volunteered to help the annex and those who sign up to get their treat bags ready, your work meeting is this Wednesday after school in the forum. Plan to stay 1 to 2 hours. For those of you who have finished their leafleting for their routes, please return the maps and envelope to Ms. O'Keefe in room 211. Thank you to all the classes that signed up for a pumpkin. They will be delivered to the period one classes this morning. Classes will have until 9 a.m. on Friday to decorate or carve their pumpkin for the contest. Student Council is also hosting a modified version of the Period 1 Dress Up Your Teacher costume competition. Teachers, you can sign up for this contest until Wednesday. Please see the email from Mr. Tribuco for more details. As a Halloween treat, Student Council is selling individually wrapped candy apples via school cash online for only $2. Cash orders cannot be accepted due to COVID-19 protocols. You can order until 2:30 p.m. today. You get to enjoy your candy apple on Friday. Any law students from last year interested in participating in this year's Tweety Moot are asked to go to room 300 to Ms. Valeris Tortiz at any point during the day to sign up. The Tweety Moot is Wednesday, and in order to register, you have to advise Ms. Tortiz of your Twitter handle. This year's issue up for debate is, should we change the law that permits corporal punishments for children? Attention grade 12s, Ontario, attention grade 12s. On Thursday, Mohawk College will be conducting another virtual presentation, this time after school at 6 p.m. This will be another opportunity to ask any questions you may have regarding Mohawk College or college life in general. The Zoom meeting link and email address for the Mohawk College representative is posted on the Grade 12 LMS. Do you need Christian service volunteer hours? Grade 12 students must have 20 hours in order to graduate this year. All other grades must complete the 40 hours before graduation. You can earn up to 12 hours this week by registering for the Terry Fox Run and Run for Rachel at hwcdsbcs.com. Complete the 5-kilometer walk or one on your own and fundraise. The deadline to complete this is October the 29th. Please see Mrs. Verasso if you need help with your registration. After a long 20-month break from basketball due to the pandemic, our senior balls basketball team made its return to action this week in the CM Sports Invitational in Scarborough. The boys hit the ground running with big victories throughout pool play, going 3-0 in first place. They then went on to win the semis against East Prep, which led us to the finals against Kennedy from Windsor. The boys led for the majority of the game, leading at three quarters 43-40. However, the boys ran out of steam in the fourth quarter after playing back-to-back-to-back games on Saturday and lost 57-50. Overall, the boys played very well this weekend and had contributions from everyone that stepped on the floor. The coaches are very happy to be back playing basketball again and can't wait for the upcoming season and the ongoing improvement of the team. Great work, guys. Thank you to all the parents who volunteered to drive this weekend. The coaches really appreciate it. The next practice is this Thursday at 7 p.m. Thank you from coaches Fortino and Harvey. Good luck to the senior girls basketball team who plays in their last regular league game today at 3:30 against St. Mary's in the Gale Dome. Teachers, please allow members of your team to leave class at 2:15. There will also be one last tryout for the juniors boys basketball team tomorrow at 7 o'clock in the morning. Players are to meet Mr. Susie at the Wilson Street entrance between 6:45 and 7. Also for Mr. Susie, with teacher's permission, could the members of the junior girls basketball team please meet Mr. Susie in room 109 after the announcement this morning? There will also be a junior football meeting today after school in room 204. Thank you from the coaches. And lastly, this is a reminder that Homework Club begins today at 2:45 in the library. And those are all of your announcements for today, Cathedral. Have a great day, girls, and thanks for watching.